Welcome to a new vlog. My name is Michael Minnebo. I'm a freelance journalist and I write about comics and popular culture. I thought it might be a good idea to do a proper introduction to this channel so I can tell you a little bit about myself and we get to know each other a little bit better. I'm a Dutch journalist. I was born in the Netherlands in 1977, so I'm a child of the 80s basically, and I was brought up, that might surprise you, on a lot of American television and movies, because a lot of series and films were available in the Netherlands in those days. What did I watch? Well, for instance, I watched Knight Rider, the television series with David Hasselhoff. I still love that series, actually. It's one of my favorites. I loved the car, and I loved Hasselhoff as Michael Knight. But also the A-Team, of course. Later on, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, X-Files, movies like Ghostbusters and Tim Burton's Batman, Blade Runner, and Star Trek. I loved Star Trek as a kid, and Star Wars, and I still love Star Trek. I'm not that fond of the latest Star Wars installments, but I still have a warm place in my heart for episode 4, 5, and 6. When I grew up, there was a lot of stuff from the United States, like He-Man and other animation series, and also Marvel Comics and DC Comics. There was a little comic book shop in the place I was born and where I lived as a kid. The place is called Horen. It's about 35 miles from Amsterdam. And there was this comic book shop, and they had just a lot of comics, European comics, so comic books, and a lot of translated comics, because there was a publisher in the 1980s and 1990s that was called Junior Press, and they translated Marvel Comics and DC Comics. So when I was young, I came across Marvel superheroes for the first time, and the heroes from DC. I was at a friend's house, and I was about 9 years old, and this friend had a big pile of comics on the coffee table in the living room, and they were all translated Marvel Comics. And I said, like, well, what the hell is this, man? This looks great. And he introduced me to Spider-Man. And I was in love with that character from that first moment. And he explained who Peter Parker was and what his powers were. And from that moment on, my fascination with the Marvel Universe and Spider-Man and superheroes in general began. This is me at the age 10 in a homemade Spider-Man costume. And, well, you know, this is what I looked like back then. That's how my love affair with superheroes started. And 30 years later, I wrote this book about my love of Spider-Man and superheroes. In this book, I use my personal experience as being of being a Spider-Man fan, and I connect that to general experiences of fans. So, for instance, when I talk about how I became a Spider-Man fan, just like how I described it to you just now, I tell about how people become fans of something or someone in general. Of course, there's a lot of similarities in that respect. I also talk about, with great power, there must also come great responsibility. And I talk with a philosopher about Spider-Man's motto and how we can apply that when we don't have superior powers. Because most of us don't. I don't know about you, but I certainly don't. And if I did have superpowers, I wouldn't admit them on camera, of course. So this book is about a lot of stuff, but at the core, it's about my love for Spider-Man and superheroes. My buddy Spider-Man Superheroes, a Geeks and Fan Culture. It's not available in America or in English at the moment, but we're working on that, so maybe in the future you can read it if you'd like. But from an early age on, I was fascinated by American culture and superheroes and comics in particular, and also movies. And my favorite superheroes are still basically the same list of the guys I read back then. Spider-Man is number one, but I also like Batman a lot.
Iron Man.
I have a soft spot for Wolverine and the Hulk. And this year, for instance, I started reading Spawn for the first time. And now I'm 150 issues in, and I'm still fascinated by this character. So when it comes to my list of favorite characters, I must add Spawn at the moment, and Doctor Strange. I like Doctor Strange as well. Anyway, in the mid-90s, when I was in my teens, I lived in the United States for a year in Berkeley, California. And that was quite an experience. On a lot of levels, and I did some traveling through the United States. I went to LA and New York, Washington and Boston, and later I came back to New York to look for the locations of the Spider-Man comics. And that's also part of my book, of the journey of this book. It was lovely to go to certain locations from Marvel Comics and see where Peter and MJ got married on the steps of City Hall, and went to the Brooklyn Bridge where Gwen Stacy was murdered by the Green Goblin, and a couple of other places. I went to the Chelsea area because Peter was living in an apartment in Chelsea Street in the 1980s, and I was looking for that particular apartment, which it's impossible to find because the street he lived on, Chelsea Street, doesn't exist in New York. So, and I know that for sure because I asked the mailman and he said, well, there's no Chelsea Street here. And but there were a couple of buildings that looked quite similar to the building he was living in the comics. So that was great. Amsterdam Comic Book Geek, that's my name, and this channel will be about comics in general. So maybe I'll bring a European perspective to American culture. I'm not sure how that will work, but we'll see. I hope we'll start a conversation about the comics we love, and maybe the comics we don't love, and the characters that's been so important in my life and yours probably. So I'm curious to hear who your favorite superheroes are, or favorite comic book characters. Because could we call the Sandman a superhero? No, Neil Gaiman's Sandman, but those are lovely, colorful characters as well. So yeah, come on guys, tell me what kind of comics you like. What was your first meeting with your favorite character? Well, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys soon, and I hope to read some of your comments below in this video. All right, until next time, cheers.